Well, Freddy here and I, him and I, we've been running. Been running for about 6 months now. I've read it. Things have changed, you know. Not like we want to, but it's the last resort that we had. I mean, I don't even have any money to, like, feed them. But, you know, we got 4 months to go, and after about 4 months, we'll be heading over to, like, probably, like, Baton Rouge area. We met some people that, you know, had this, like, sawhorse and pubic hair shaving, like a heart shape, but, I mean, that's apart from the story, but I know some people there, and they said they give us a place to stay, food to eat, a couple places to go hang out at, and, well, I figured, you know, Freddy cakes are very, we can do with a good bath and a meal, and, you know, I mean, he's loyal, he's definitely loyal, I mean, look at him, I mean, he's been by my side the whole time, and, I mean, I'm not gonna complain. You know, through thick or thin, Freddy here, I mean, it's not like he has anybody else to hang out with, but it's like, you know, he knows how things get, and, you know, he wants to come hang out. He wants to be a part of it. And I wouldn't trade him for anything, you know. But from Baton Rouge, I think we might be heading up to, maybe Chicago for a little bit, you know. See, you know, the Chi-Town, what it's got to offer, you know. But there's a lot of different ways to look at the situation. I mean, we got places to go, people to see. I mean, we might not be able to be here for that much longer, you know, but when you're on the go, and you're going for the go, nowhere to go. But wherever you go, there you are. And Freddy's a master of traveling. I mean, he's like a little hungry nomad, you know? Freddy is a hungry nomad. I mean, that's what's been keeping me going with him, you know? I try to latch on to that hungry nomad type, that personality he's got going on. He's training for a while without me before I met him, you know? He's with this one traveling, they had a leader, Macacon, or there was Macacon, and there was Hibia was balancing things, and but Macacon was, you know, I met Macacon, we were at this pawn shop, I was looking at this fender base, it was one of those small fender bases, you know, it was like might have been a 68 or something, but I was asking Macacon, like, you know, what it would be like to have Freddy here on my team. You know, Macacon, he wanted a lot of money. You know, he knew what he was capable of, you know? You know, and they had been through a lot too, you know, I mean, but it's a contract job, you know? He's professional. He knows when to drop a loyalty and go to another loyalty instead of wasting time